moot video or still cameras, please include the ASL interpreter, particularly TV cameras, so that folks listening will be able to, everyone will be able to understand what's being said. Thank you. I'm joined today by Commissioner Jean Lambrew, Commissioner of Department of Health and Human Services, and Commissioner Heather Johnson of the Department of Economic and Community Development. Well, like many people, I breathed a sigh of relief Friday when I was informed that the police had found the body of Robert Card. Their discovery meant that Mr. Card was no longer a threat to anyone else. But it also meant that Lewiston and the entire state of Maine could take the first small step in the long road to healing. In the wake of this tragedy, I have seen the very best of Maine people. And last night in Lewiston, I saw people from all across Maine fill the historic Basilica of St. Peter and St. Paul, when more than 1,000 stood outside as well, standing arm in arm in the cold to honor those who lost their lives and those who were harmed, and just to be together with one another. People of different backgrounds, different faiths, different races, all united by an unwavering compassion and an unbreakable love for one another, for Lewiston, and for Maine. In the face of great difficulty and tragedy, it is the hallmark of Maine people to come together to love and support one another. And that's what brings me here today. Today I want to keep the people of Maine informed about what my administration is doing in close partnership with communities across the state. And I want to tell you what you can do to help as well. In memory of those we've lost, I'm ordering that all United States and State of Maine flags remain lowered through sunset Friday, November 17th. That's an additional 18 days to honor each person who was taken from us by this unspeakable tragedy. My heart continues to go out to anyone who's lost a loved one, and know that while the manhunt has ended, the search for justice will continue. To that end, the Maine State Police are continuing their thorough investigation to determine the facts and circumstances surrounding these attacks, so we can bring whatever closure we may to the victims and their families and to the community at large. As that investigation continues, my administration has worked with the Office of the Attorney General, the FBI, and the Red Cross to establish the Family Assistance Center at the Lewiston Armory. That's at 65 Central Avenue in Lewiston. That's a space where victims and their families, a non-public space, where they can access comprehensive services like mental health counseling, financial aid, spiritual aid, and victim advocacy services. We've also launched a mental health assistance center located at the Ramada Inn at 490 Pleasant Street in Lewiston to provide counseling and support for the broader community. Everyone's feeling pretty bad. A lot of people need help. My administration has created a dedicated web page of behavioral health resources, including suggestions on how to talk with children about what happened. And you can review that website at maine.gov/DHHS. This administration remains in close contact with Lewiston schools and schools in the surrounding areas to make sure they have full access to services and supports for students and staff. As kids return to school, clinicians and counselors will be available to support them. We also remain in touch with hospitals and healthcare providers and to check in on the well-being of their incredible staff who also have been through an awful lot. Tomorrow, the Department of Health and Human Services will launch an online form that will allow communities or organizations to request special behavioral health help, like on-site mental health clinics or support that's tailored for different communities. If you're someone who needs help, please don't wait. Just call 988. I also recognize that this tragedy has been hard on small businesses, especially those in Lewis and Auburn and surrounding areas. Those businesses are an important part of their communities, and they remained closed during the shelter-in-place order to allow for law enforcement to do their work. My administration, through the Department of Economic and Community Development, is reaching out to those businesses in the coming days and working with the Federal Small Business Administration and the Lewis and Auburn Chamber of Commerce to access any financial support that may be available to help those businesses through this difficult time. My office also remains in contact with the White House, and I am pleased to report that, at my request, the Deputy Director of the White House Office of Gun Violence Prevention is in Lewiston today. He will serve as the primary point of contact for my administration in coordinating the federal government's deployment of resources and support. Those resources include staff, people, and that includes a mobile medic team that'll be in Maine tomorrow and Wednesday to support first responders and veterans. A team from the Department of Justice who will be in Maine Wednesday to help victims file for federal compensation. And a team from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services arriving in Maine today to support our health care providers. My administration's efforts will evolve as the needs of the community and the needs of our state evolve. Your support throughout all of this will be crucial. What can you do to help, you're asking? Over the weekend, we launched the Healing Together online resource that identifies places that are accepting financial donations to support victims, families, first responders, and organizations that are all helping in the wake of last week's tragic shooting. Please visit my website at maine.gov/governor/mills to access those resources and those websites. At the top of the website, you'll see Healing Together, Support for Lewiston. The donations you make there will go to support the families of victims and those who were injured and those directly impacted by the violence. I urge you to join me in giving what you can and in spreading the word. An important part of our response in the coming weeks will be to understand exactly what happened and ask ourselves what changes are needed to fully protect the safety of Maine people. My administration's focus right now is on fully investigating and understanding the facts and circumstances that led to last week's tragedy and making sure that the families of the victims, and those who are recovering, and those who are struggling in Lewiston and throughout Maine are fully supported during this difficult time. But as we begin to travel down the long and difficult road of recovery, make no mistake, I believe the people of Maine deserve a serious and robust conversation about gun violence and public safety at the state and federal levels in the coming weeks. To that end, I want to bring together legislative leaders on both sides of the aisle, along with public safety officials, public health people, members of the judicial system, advocates on all sides, psychiatrists, community members, and others, for a thoughtful and comprehensive discussion. I believe action is needed. What that action will be must be the product of a broad discussion among a diverse group of voices. The people of Maine deserve this discussion. And now, before I close, I want to acknowledge that many of us have been feeling a wide range of emotions, from shock to sadness, from anxiety to fear, from grief to anger. I felt many of these emotions myself over the last several days, and I'm sure we'll continue to feel things in the coming days and weeks and months. And I want the people of Maine to know this. If you feel this way, it's okay. It's okay. Each of us feels differently. Each person mourns differently. Each person grieves differently. But what's not different, what each of us has in common, is that we are not alone. We're not alone in our feelings, in our mourning, in our grieving. These last 5 days have shown that the exact opposite is true, that we are together. We're here for each other. We're here for you. For we are carrying a heavy pain, but that burden is made lighter when we carry it together. From this day on, struggling as we may, let us wrap our arms around one another, offering comfort, compassion, solace, and love. We will heal together. Thank you. May God bless the people of Lewiston and the people of Maine. I'll take a few questions. Hi.
How are you?
Hi.
Thank you for your Shimon Grover has received it. I need to get your reaction to our reporting that the sheriff there, where the shooter lived, had investigated him, had been to his home, appears on several occasions. At one point, the deputy was there. It appears he was inside the home, but they took no further action despite knowing and receiving information that he was a threat. What is your reaction to that? I know you talk a lot about investigation, but if law enforcement doesn't use the tools that are available to them, how are people supposed to feel safe?
You're reporting on reports, and I know it's second, third. Excuse me. You're reporting on something that has not been finally determined, and I think that determining and understanding all the facts surrounding this event is crucial. All of the facts. The Maine State Police is, as I said, undergoing a thorough investigation of every aspect of the case. Facts are important, and it's an important question that you ask. There are many other important questions that will be determined in the coming weeks and months. The Maine people deserve an answer to these questions, all of them, and that will happen in due course.
But are you concerned?
I'm sorry, next question.
Excuse me. Governor.
Yes, somebody had their hand up. Yes, hi.
Can you please describe what police did to find Mr. Carter after the state's order that after located him in September and why he wasn't found at that time?
I couldn't hear you the first.
Would you please tell us what police did in September after the statewide order to find Mr. Carter went out and why he wasn't found at that time?
Again, you're asking a law enforcement investigative question, and I think those questions are important, but but I can assure you those questions will be answered in due course as the police conduct all appropriate interviews and determine the facts of this case. I trust the Maine State Police to determine to undergo a thorough investigation of all aspects of the case.
Right, but Governor, there's this appearance.
Yes, sir.
There's an appearance of a lack of.
Excuse me. You've had your turn. Thank you.
No, you're not answering the question,
sir. Sir.
The Legislative Council obviously has to meet soon to decide legislation for 2024. So if I could just push you a little bit, what maybe specifics do you think you need to think about in the meantime, given there is kind of a tight deadline ahead of next session? And I guess some ideas, too, have been floated already, like the assault style weapons ban or red flag.
What was the last of that?
Extremist.
Oh, okay. Look, there are a lot of ideas out there. And again, I think action is needed. What that action is must be the product of a broad discussion, comprehensive discussion among diverse voices. I'm not going to stand here today and tell you that I'm proposing XYZ, but I'm here to listen and to work with others, get people around the table as promptly as possible, and listen to people first and foremost and see what we might best do to ensure the safety of the Maine people.
Governor,
I'm sorry, yes?
Are red flag laws, for example, on the table?
I'm not taking anything off the table. There are a lot of ideas out there. They may have names, they may have acronyms and all, but I'm willing to listen to all voices.
Governor,
I can't see you.
Governor, I'd like to ask why vehicles listen are.
I'm sorry, who is this?
Oh, sorry.
I can't see you there.
Sorry.
Okay.
I want to know why vehicles listen are learning 4 or 5 days after the mass shooting that there was apparently a warning a month ago about this exact suspect potentially carrying out a mass shooting, and why they're learning about it from, like you said, reports rather than their governor. Have you seen the sheriff's office police report? Has anyone in the state government seen it?
I can't answer that. I'll just tell you, I am not a law enforcement officer, but I do have great faith in Commissioner Sawchuk and members of the Maine State Police. This is not an easy, quick and easy investigation. And it hasn't stopped just by the finding of Mr. Card's body. It's ongoing and continues. And it takes a lot of people and a lot of work to determine the answers. And I will wait to hear from them after a thorough and appropriate investigation by law enforcement into those kinds of reports and assumptions. Excuse me, I'm not. Excuse me. Please lower your voice, please. I'm not here to argue. Excuse me.
Certainly, the families deserve to know about what law enforcement knew and about what you know.
Thank you for your question. Yes, sir.
Are you reconsidering your opposition to sorting gun laws in the bus?
I think it's pretty clear that I actually have helped draft some pretty significant gun legislation, and we're going to be part of the remedy. Part of the solution. We're going to sit down and listen to all points of view and all folks with different viewpoints about how we can best protect Maine people. That's what I'm willing to do. That's what I've always been willing to do and what I'll do in the coming weeks. Yes, sir.
You run the state police.
Excuse me.
You run the state police.
Hello. Yes.
It seems as though information was not shared to federal authorities when they knew that they had information about.
So who's the they?
Why was that not shared?
I don't know what you're referring to now. They.
Information that was received by local police that they had about the shooter that they did not share.
They meaning.
Governor, you really don't know what we're talking about?
Sir, I've answered the question.
This needs to be answered. Yeah, Governor. I'm sorry.
It's under investigation. Please don't argue with me, sir. Please don't. That's not what we do in Maine. We don't argue with people like this.
We know that there is an alarming concern from the law enforcement community that activity and information here was ignored? And the simple answer is, why was that done, and are you concerned about that?
I think those kinds of facts are yet to be determined. You're making assumptions. I'm not willing to make those assumptions. All right?
Thank you very much. We're going to wrap there. We appreciate your time.
I'm sorry, what? They're continuing to respond and continuing to investigate who knew what when, and we want to get at the best answer to how can we prevent something like this from happening, and that includes why did it happen in the first place, and what what measures may have been in place that weren't used or were used, and that's what we'll get to the bottom of.
Thank you all very much. Thank you.
Have a good day.